G'day, I'm Jim. We've recently returned from an expedition in search of a Waddi tree. This Waddi tree, or acacia puce, was staked and measured by John Fan on an exhibition led by my father, Murray Upton, in 1972. We revisited many of the sites that my father went to in 1972. We also retraced Cecil Madigan's 1939 trip to Old Andado Station. We found the Waddi tree near Northport on Old Andado Station. It was also here Cecil Madigan departed on his expedition across the Simpson Desert to Birdsville. As you can see, Northport is no longer operational. The homestead at Old Andado Station remains intact, preserved inside and out, just as it was 80 years ago when Cecil Madigan was there.
Looking forward, looking back, I've come a long way down the track. Got a long way left to go.
The sand dune you can see in the background, or the sand ridge as they used to be called, is the exact same one that gave so much grief to Cecil Madigan on his approach to Andado Station. The run up the sand dune is much easier these days, as you can see. Unable to get to Birdsville because of two flood events, we went through 13 kilometres of flooded water from Nakundra to Innaminka. The Cooper was in full flood and we had to relocate due to the rising waters, a far cry from my last trip there in 2008. We travelled down the Strzelecki track and then up to Farina Station, where a lot of hard work has been put in to restore some of the old buildings. The Maree pub had not changed a real lot since the family visited in 1971. Maree was one of the main stops for the Ghan. Little remains of the narrow gauge Ghan track these days. Madigan shifted his gear and camels on the Ghan in 1939.
Looking forward, looking back, I've come a long way down the track.
We ventured up the Birdsville track. And then west, off the track, to the flooding Warburton Creek, or river. Back onto the Udnadatta track.
Looking forward, looking back.
Lake air was just beginning to fill for the first time in many years. There was also water in the lake in 1971 when we visited.
Looking forward, looking back.
And north to Coward Springs. The hotel is no longer there, however, it is a great spot to camp. In Kibapudi, some things don't change, and other things change a lot. One thing that does not change is the Gibber Plains. The hard rocky surface just seems to go on forever. The Transcontinental Hotel at Udnadatta had not changed much either. The modes of transport getting there and back have changed over the years. Although the escarpments and mountains have not. The rocks near Culgra are still spectacular.
Looking forward, looking back, I've come a long way down the track. Got a long way left to go, making songs from what I know.